Yeah, so there are, I won't go into all of these reasons, but let's cover a few. So one of them is when you is it also depends on what type of application that you're using. If you're, so for example, a firefighter simulation where you really have to, and that's perhaps the most ideal form of VR, really interactive, where you have hands, where you can, where you really try to mimic a real world situation as closely as possible. You try to come to the real activity as closely as possible. Yeah, of course that works because you build muscle memory and you involve your entire body into it, and you have you feel the tension of when a situation goes wrong. So there are all these different factors that make that learning process just way better than than watching a video or reading about it theoretically. We're not isolated. Our brains are not isolated things in a vat. No, we're embodied beings. We use our bodies to learn things, and we're emotionally involved. And then other elements which can also be, which are perhaps easier to reach. So one of them is emotional involvement, and that's actually quite well measured, that people who wear VR headsets and are put into a situation are emotionally more involved than watching a video. And you can do that to mimic stressful situations, to see how you would react in a stressful situation. You can do that, you can use that to create empathy for people, which is also, especially when you're doing social studies or health or when you're becoming a healthcare professional. Yeah, how do you empathize with your patients, and what do they go through, and how what's it like to be a patient when you do a certain thing? So empathy, building empathy can be a really powerful can be really powerful when you use VR for that. And a third way I wanted to talk about is much easier to get to, I think, is and it's more aimed at learning knowledge, and that's to actually build context around to build context and thereby making things less abstract. So then you don't have to need, when you're teaching kids about living underwater, living on the bottom of the ocean, and you show two pictures, and they have to learn what kind of animals there live in what kind of animals live kilometers under the sea. Yeah, that's still really abstract, right? But if you take them, if you put them on, if you put the VR headset on them, and you actually take them to the depths of of the world, and you make things really concrete, you make things really like come to life. And especially when a teacher is there, then to sort of link those abstract concepts with these experiences, I think that's where that's the way we make meaning, right? Meaning is created in our brains when we make a lot of, when we bring context to concepts, when we make a lot of connections to other topics, when we make connections to embodied emotional experiences, and not just reading abstract concepts in a book. I think that's the easiest thing to get to, because you don't need a completely, it doesn't have to, you can use, and you can use a documentary, a 360 video shot for a documentary, or you can use Google Earth, or you can use all these resources which aren't really meant for education or anything, but they do give a rich context, and the teacher can link those abstract concepts to that rich context. We tend to forget that our abstract notions are based in real experiences, and that when our students haven't had those experiences, it's it, our message isn't really coming through. So yeah, we're not, things in our whole schooling system, many things are still really abstract, and you just and sometimes I have nothing against abstractness. So the whole mathematics is abstract, but because it's so it's so great because it's abstract, because it goes, it's about everything. It's not only about specific examples. But if you can make things less abstract, I think that can really help students.